Welcome students, this is Varsha CBSE Maths 10th 8th lesson trigonometry lesson. So this is your exercise 6.8.3. So this is the starting of the exercise, question number 1. So we are going to do the first question in the exercise 8.3. So this is your first question, sine 18 by cos 72, and second question is tan 26 by cos 64, cos 48 minus sine 42, then cosecant 31 minus secant 59. So this is what your question. Okay, so the first question, sine 18. So see, sine 18 can be written as, write your sine. See, 18 can be written as 90 minus 72. Okay, is that okay? 72, when you subtract 90 minus 72, you will get 18. Okay, so you have wrote for 18 for 90 minus 72 divided by cos 72. So this is the formula. What formula it is? Sine 90 minus theta. So this is your theta. So you can write cos theta, that is 72 degree by cos 72 degree. So you can cancel. So you will get your answer 1. Okay, so what is the formula we have used here, students? So tan 90 minus theta equal to cos theta. So this is the formula we have used. See, do you understand? Sine 90 minus theta. So which theta is here? You can write cos theta. So here 72 is that. So you can write cos 72. Okay, now go to the second sum. See, here also the same sum. See, this is tan. You write the tan. 26 can be written as 90 minus 64. Okay, when you subtract 90 minus 64, you will get 26. Okay, so we replace 26 for 90 minus 64 by cot 64. Okay, students, do you understand? I have written 26. Okay, 90 for 64. Okay, so 90 minus 64 is 26. Tan, you have to write the tan. You should not change the tan. You have changed 26 into 90 minus 64. Okay, the denominator as it is, you have written. See, this is the formula, tan 90 minus theta. So this can be written as cot 64 by cot 64. So if you cancel, you will get the answer 1. Okay, do you understand? Yes, now go to the second question. So this is cos 48. So how will you write cos 48? See what formula here we used. The tan 90 minus theta equal to cot theta. So this is the formula we have used in the sum. Okay, students. So now go to the third question. Cos 48 minus sine 42. So you can change any of the one. Okay, so I took cos 48. See, how will you write cos 48? Write cos. For 48, you have write 90 minus 42. Sine 42, it is not changing. You write as it is. So cos 90 minus theta, you can write sine theta. So that is sine 72. Sorry, 42. So sine 42, sine 42, that is 0. So this is what your answer. So what is the formula we have used? That is, cos 90 minus theta equal to sine theta. Okay, do you understand? This is the formula we have used in the sum. So now go to the fourth question. Cosecant 31 minus secant 51. So you are going to change cosecant. Okay, so what is the formula? First you write the formula. So cosecant 90 minus theta can be written as secant theta. Okay, so see, cosecant, write your cosecant as it is. So 31 you are going to change 90 minus 59 minus secant 59. So this is cosecant 90 minus theta. So this is can be written as secant 59. So secant 59. So both are equal. So when you subtract, you get 0 as the answer. Okay, students, do you understand? So this is the first sum. You have four subdivisions. We have done the four subdivisions. Okay, I hope you all understand. So after seeing the video, please do the sum on your own. Okay, thank you, students.